In this week's parsha, beginning of the parsha, it's a very famous parsha. Avraham Avinu was sitting outside the Chaim Hayoim, and he was looking for Orchim, and then HaKadosh Baruch Hu got three Malachim, sent three Malachim, dressed up as people, and that was Orchim. And Avraham Avinu left Hashem, and he was in the middle of speaking to Hashem. He left and he went to get towards the Orchim to bring them into his house. So there's a Gemara that says that we see from over here that Gadol Hachnasas Orchim, the mitzvah of Hachnasas Orchim, is greater Gadola mikabolas pnei Hashchina. It's greater than accepting Hashem, than speaking to Hashem. Because Avraham Avinu left from Kabbalas pnei Hashchina and he went to do the mitzvah of Hachnasas Orchim. So there's a kasha here which a lot of the Achrayim ask. So very good. Avraham Avinu went ahead and he left Hashem to go ahead and be Mekabel the Orchim, to go ahead and be Machnes Eirich. The question is the whole Gemara in Sukkah. And the Gemara in Sukkah says, Ha'oisik b'mitzvah, someone who's in the middle of busying himself with a mitzvah, Potter min ha'mitzvah. He's Potter from doing another mitzvah. Someone who's doing mitzvah A is Potter from doing mitzvah B. He doesn't have to do mitzvah B.
Is that the rule? That's what they say.
That's the Gemara. That's the rule. That's halacha
l'maisa. It
is. Yeah, halacha l'maisa. Ha'isik b'mitzvah potter min ha'mitzvah.
You don't have to daven. There's man krishma.
So we'll see. Yeah. Ha'isik b'mitzvah potter min ha'mitzvah is in everything. If someone's in the middle of giving tzedakah, as man krishma comes. As a matter of fact, I just heard recently a story with Reb Chaim Oizer Grozansky, who was a big Rosh Hashiva in Vilna, that he was in his house. He was on his way to go daven mincha. And in the middle, as he's going to daven mincha, because before the end of the day, he's going to daven mincha, and someone comes in with his wife to visit Reb Chaim Oizer. And they went, and Reb Chaim Oizer says, okay, let's sit down. He invites them in, and then he says to the person, to the man, to the husband, come, let's daven mincha, and then we'll come back. And he went to the side room, and he daven mincha. And he says to him, why aren't you going to shul to daven mincha? Why are you davening mincha in your house? Why are you davening mincha by yechidus? So he says, what do you mean? I should go to shul to daven mincha and leave your wife here by yourself? Kedoy lachnasas orchim, yoysim mikabalas p'nei shchina. Ha'oisik b'mitzvah potem min ha'mitzvah, he's in middle doing lachnasas orchim, he's not mechuyiv to go to shul to daven mincha, and he daven mincha by yechidus in his house. You see, halacha l'maisa. So, ha'oisik b'mitzvah potem min ha'mitzvah, there happens to be the machlokes and the rishonim, because the rishonim have a kasha. What's the chiddush that if someone's doing one mitzvah, he's potter from doing another mitzvah? What's the chiddush? Of course, I'm in the middle of doing one mitzvah. Why should I leave mitzvah A to do mitzvah B?
Mitzvah A, you're not commanded to do. Mitzvah B, you are.
Who says you're not commanded?
Yes, you are.
You are commanded.
But you're not.
Okay, we'll see. We'll get to that. Every mitzvah you're commanded in.
But what's the one is?
Okay, we'll see. We'll get to it.
Doing something
here, we'll get to it. So that's what we get to today. So if you're doing mitzvah A, you're potter to do mitzvah B. So the Shreya Mavakasha, what's the chiddush? Mitzvah A, leave a mitzvah, do mitzvah B. Why should I give up mitzvah A and do mitzvah B? So some of the Rishonim want to say that the chiddush is that even if it's possible to do both of them, I'm doing mitzvah A. I could stop for a minute, do mitzvah B, and come back to do mitzvah A. Some of the Rishonim learn, you're still potter from doing mitzvah B. As long as you're in the middle of doing mitzvah A, even though it's possible to do both, even though it's possible to do mitzvah B also, a lot of Rishonim say that is the chiddush of oisik b'mitzvah potter b'mitzvah, they don't have to leave mitzvah A to do mitzvah B. It's one pshat in the Rishonim. It's another pshat in the Rishonim, and this is a Ritva. A very famous Ritva in this sugya. The Ritva says like this, that if I'm doing mitzvah A, so now I want to leave and do mitzvah B. I decide I want to do mitzvah B and leave mitzvah A. So without the chiddush of oisik b'mitzvah potter min ha'mitzvah, you would say, okay, so if you want, you can leave mitzvah A and do mitzvah B. Comes the Gemara tells us that if someone is doing a mitzvah A and he wants to do mitzvah B, he's not allowed to go ahead and do mitzvah B. It's awesome. Not an oisik b'mitzvah potter min ha'mitzvah, he doesn't have to do it. He's not allowed to do mitzvah B and leave mitzvah A. That's the chiddush. Someone's doing mitzvah A, he's not allowed to leave it and do mitzvah B. Now you want to talk to the Maisa. So I'll tell you what Shari Tzvi in the Mishnah Berurah. Okay? There's a Mishnah Berurah here in Hilchas Pesach. If someone, Nebuch was, there's times that he's well, he's not well, sometimes he's with it, and sometimes he's not with it, he doesn't know what's going on. He's a din of a shaytah. Shaytah doesn't know what's going on. So it comes Pesach night, and there's times that he's with it, times that he's not with it. So the times that he's not with it, he ate matzah. Now, an hour later, he becomes with it. Was he yaitzeh his chi of mitzvah of matzah or not? Because the shaita is potim in our mitzvahs. So now, when he comes to, and he knows what's going on, he should have to eat matzah again. So says the Mechaber, Ochel gezayit matzah vo nichfeh ba'esh etusay. It was in a time period where he's not well, doesn't know what's going on. Va'achar kach nisrape, and then he got healed. Chayiv lechol achar shenisrape. He's mechuyiv to eat again, gezayit matzah, after he gets healed. Why? Because the matzah that he ate when he was potter, it can't be yoitzeh his chiyuv for when he's chayiv. Now he gets better. He knows what's going on. Now he has a chiyuv to eat matzah. So he has a new chiyuv to eat matzah, even though he already ate matzah an hour ago. But when he ate matzah an hour ago, he wasn't with it. Therefore, he's potter. Therefore, he's chayiv to eat a second time. Says the Shari Tzion. That is only if the first time he ate matzah, he wasn't with it. He didn't know what was going on. How about if a person is being oisik b'mitzvah? The halacha is, someone who's oisik b'mitzvah is potter min ha-mitzvah. He doesn't have to do another mitzvah. So how about if someone was being shomer ha-meis? He's watching a dead person. He's oisik b'mitzvah, he's watching a dead person. Now he eats matzah while he's watching a dead person. He's potter from eating matzah. Oisik b'mitzvah, potter min ha-mitzvah. He doesn't have to eat matzah if he doesn't want. He eats matzah while he's potter, and then he finished. Now he's not being shomer the mason, not watching that person anymore, and now he has a chiyuv to eat matzah. Does he have to eat matzah a second time or not? So Shari Tzion says that even though he ate it b'shas p'tur when he was potter, still, if he was with it, he's ready to the mitzvah. But he says he has a suffix. Mr. Pakna, I have a suffix. Im yuchal oz levorech birchas achilas matzah, asher kedishonu b'mitzvoysa v'tzivonu, kivin shu oz eine mitzvah. Says the Shari Tzion, and he says the Tzorachin. I'm not sure if a person is doing a mitzvah, oisik b'mitzvah, he's watching a mace. And now he goes ahead, and he eats matzah while he's being shamed with the mace. He's potter from eating matzah. Is he allowed to make a bracha Asher kidishonu b'mitzvoysa v'tzivonu al achilas matzah? So you see, he's potter. If a guy is being shamed in a mesa whole night Leil Pesach, he's potter from eating matzah. He does not have to eat matzah. Right? No, he's not mechuyiv to eat matzah. He's not mechuyiv to eat matzah.
He loses the mitzvah.
He doesn't lose the mitzvah.
Well, of course he does.
He's potter from the mitzvah.
But he's not doing
he's
it.
He's potter from the mitzvah.
But he doesn't get a mitzvah.
Okay, could be. He's bigger mitzvah. He's doing a different mitzvah.
Okay.
He's doing another mitzvah. So oisik min ha-mitzvah, potter min ha-mitzvah, is halacha l'maisa. So here, Avraham Avinu was oisik b'mitzvah of Kabbalah's Pnei Shechina. Now he's leaving that, and he's going ahead to be machnes oirich. How's he allowed to do that? Oisik b'mitzvah, potter min ha-mitzvah, according to the Ritva, it means he's not allowed to go ahead and do the second mitzvah. He has to continue doing the first mitzvah. How was Avraham Avinu allowed to leave the first mitzvah of Kabbalah's Pnei Shechina and go ahead and do the second mitzvah of Achnas Hashem?
He didn't have the luck to tell.
You know what?
He didn't have the luck to tell.
Kabbalah Shechina is different.
Why?
Because Kabbalah Shechina is... Now the Shechina wants you to do something else. To Zalp Shechina. As opposed to some other mitzvah.
Yeah. Okay, could be.
The Shechina who's doing the mitzvah.
No,
Avraham
is doing a mitzvah. Kabbalah's Pnei Shechina is a mitzvah. To be Kabbalah, the Pnei Shechina is a mitzvah. We'll get to that, what that mitzvah is in a second. What does that mean to be so that's what we're going to speak about now. That's the Shlomo Hyman's kasha. And the Tziv asked the kasha, they all asked the kasha.
When you have a guest, the Shechina is there.
Yeah. It's also Pnei Shechina. Okay, good. Good.
But this one here is the Shechina wants you to take care of the Arkham now.
There's a Shaila, right? There's a mitzvah Re'iyah on Yom Tov. You have to go ahead and be mekabel from the Shechina in the Beis HaMikdash. So what are you going to say? No, I'm doing something else. I'm not going to be mekabel from the Shechina. Why? Because Hashem wants me to go do the other mitzvah. No, Re'iyas Pnei Hashem is a mitzvah in itself. So you're all basically on the same mahalach of the Shlomo's Teretz, and he says that there's different types of mitzvahs. We've spoken about this before more than once. There's a mitzvah that you have to do. It's a chiyah for you to do a mitzvah. And then you have mitzvahs that are mitzvahs they don't have to do. It's a mitzvah for humans. If you want to do it, you could do it. Then he gives an example. If someone's wearing tzitzis, you're not mechuyev to wear dalat chanvois. You're not mechuyev to wear a beged with four corners to put tzitzis on it. Right? If you happen to wear dalat chanvois, you have to put tzitzis on it. It's not a chiyev to wear dalat chanvois. So he says such mitzvahs that he calls them mitzvahs that a person is not mechuyev to do constantly. For example, kabbalas pnei shechina. You don't have to do kabbalas pnei shechina. If you do it, it's a mitzvah. He says that you're allowed to leave in order to do a mitzvah of hachnasas arkham, which is, he calls, a mitzvah chiyuvis. It's a chiyuv to be mekabel pnei arkham. It's a mitzvah chiyuvis. That's what he said. So similar to what you were saying, kabbalas pnei shechina, you don't have to do every second. If you have arkham, then there's a chiyuv to do it. The problem with that teretz is that over here, Avraham Avinu, what was he doing? He was looking for Arkham. Is there a mitzvah? What does it mean, the mitzvah of Achnasas Arkham? Does the mitzvah of Achnasas Arkham mean that you mechuyev to go ahead and look for Arkham and go find them? Or when the mitzvah comes to you, you have to take them in. What is the mitzvah of Achnasas Arkham? Is it a chiyev for me to go ahead and looking around and finding chesed and doing chesed with people, whether it's Achnasas Arkham, whether it's Levayis HaMes, whatever it is? What is that mitzvah? Is that a mitzvah that I have to get up every day and look, go look around for Gemilas Chasadim? Or is it a mitzvah of, if it comes to you, go ahead and do the mitzvah? What type of mitzvah is it?
You invite guests.
Are you mechuyev to invite guests?
No, but that's where you're looking for the mitzvah, so you go and invite
them. So you go to invite them. So that's the mitzvah to me to go out and look for guests to invite? Or is the mitzvah? Example.
Didn't Avraham have every day?
Yeah, so Avraham Avinu, we see from Avraham Avinu that Avraham Avinu went ahead and he went to look for the Orchim. You see in this expression?
It wasn't typical.
Huh? It wasn't typical, right. So the question is, do we learn from Avraham Avinu
that this whole concept of Achnasas Arkham was Kirav
Chaykim. That's right. Avraham did even more. It was Kirav Chaykim. But besides that, he was Goymel Chesed. Avraham was the Amud HaChesed. Avraham Avinu was the epitome of Milas Chasodim. He went ahead and he looked for guests to bring them into his house. Is that the mitzvah? Is that the mitzvah? Is the mitzvah to go out and look for guests? Or when someone comes to you to invite them in and be machne tzarech?
That's a hell of a thing of happiness.
You look hot right there.
The color looks like Moshe. Moshe Rabbeinu. Question: that's called Achnasas Arkham. Bring somebody in and give him hot peppers. Is that what we make the sandwich?
Then you sell him water.
You okay?
You
want some water?
So that's the question over here. How do you look at the mitzvah of Achnasas Arkham? Or any Gemilas Chasadim. Any Gemilas Chasadim, what is the mitzvah? So the truth is, we don't find anywhere that the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim is to go out and look for guests and look for people to invite them. If someone needs a place, you invite them in. You know a person needs a place to eat, you invite them in. We don't find anywhere the mitzvah is to go look. I mean, there's a mitzvah to lend somebody money. Is there a mitzvah to go ahead and look for a person to lend them money? Or no, if a guy comes to you and he needs some money, you should lend him some money, you have a chiyuv to lend him money. So we don't find anywhere really the mitzvah is to go ahead and look to do a gemilas chasadim. Avraham Avinu, that's what he did. Avraham Avinu went ahead and he looked to do a gemilas chasadim. That could be a higher level. Now, there's a question, maybe we'll get to that later. First, I want to share with you big machlokes in the Achronim about Gemilas Chasadim. What is the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim? So, a guest comes to you, you have to invite him in, you have to give him to eat. There's a mechaber in Hilchos Nedarim. The mechaber says, "Im asa sifrei achaveiro." If someone says, he makes a neder, and he says, "My sfarim or any of my chafetzim are asur to somebody else." Asur the nesar lil moed boy. The person who he said to him that he's not allowed to use your sfarim, he's asur to learn from his sfarim. Why? Because it's asur b'hano. If you ask somebody to have a no from your svarim, and he goes ahead and he learns in your svarim, he's being nana from it. He's having a no from it. He's having enjoyment from it. If you ask that person from having enjoyment from your stuff, you're not allowed, he's not allowed to use your svarim. That's the mechaber. Says the Taz, a very interesting Taz. Kain kasa b'shu is maimin, heviyeh beis yesif, v'hu mitam, sh'arei, the Loshon HaTaz, ein chiyuv ala adam, lahashil sifroi l'chaveroi. A person has no chiv to lend his svarim to somebody else. Shalei the daiter against his will. K'mayisha ein chayiv olav litnoi. Sharei mekalkula bekach, he's ruining it. I'm not mechuyiv to give my sefer. If someone comes to my house and says, "Can I borrow a sefer from you?" Says the Taz, Chayiv should have to give it to him. Gemilas chasadim. Gemilas chasadim says, someone needs something, you have to help him out. Am I mechuyiv to give my svarim to somebody if he comes and he wants to borrow it? Says the Taz, you're not mechuyiv. Why? Shem mekalkalei. You use a sefer, the more you use it, the more it gets used up, you're not mechuyiv to give it to him. Umutel haskiroi, you're allowed to charge him rent for it. Venimtza ma'neyu haschah shayitzarech litein. So if someone's mudr hano, if someone's not allowed to have a no from you, and they give it to him for free, since I'm allowed to charge him rent for it, therefore he's having a no. You see from the Taz, so if someone comes to you and wants to borrow your sefer, you're not mechuyev to give it to him according to the Taz. Atzkemilas chasadim. Atzkemilas chasadim, the Taz holds, you're not mechuyev to give it to him.
But those svarim are much more expensive.
I just want to...
even today, any kilkos.
The difference with tefillin. Someone didn't have tefillin, you're allowed to borrow Yenim's tefillin without his knowledge.
Yeah, so...
Because that's not ruined.
Because
it doesn't get ruined.
Correct,
it
doesn't get ruined.
But a sefer you can't borrow.
Right, because it gets ruined. I always give the example, a very famous, someone comes to you and he wants to borrow your car. Are you mechuyev to give it to him?
I hope not, because I never do.
So most of the time, people will not lend out the car to anybody. What happened to Gemilas Chasadim? What happened to the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim?
There's a loss, potential loss. If you have an accident, you have to pay for it.
So there's a potential loss. So we'll see in a second if that's a cheshbon.
That's a pretty good cheshbon.
If someone borrows a sefer, you're scared it may not return it. Right? Okay. Happens all the time.
Many times.
Right? So you're not required to give it because of that? So first the Taz says that according to the Taz, you have nothing to worry about because there's no mitzvah to lend your kelim. Because anything you lend that gets used up, that gets ruined as a user, you're not mechuyev to give it out. Then he says, they ask a kasha from Shafer. He says, Shafer is not a question. Shafer doesn't get ruined when you use it. But she'en kein svarim, they get ruined when you use it.
This is finished.
If it drops, the usage. Anything. Then you could say, you're not mechuyev to lend anybody anything, because you could break it.
And Shafer can also get disease from it, by the way.
You what?
Mouth disease.
Okay.
That's also.
I don't. The Chafetz Chaim in Avos Chesed argues. The Chafetz Chaim in Avos Chesed, the famous sefer from the Chafetz Chaim, and he speaks about, he has a whole sefer about doing Chesed, and he says, "Tzda, you should know, oi, the lav dafka al voice mois. It's not just lending money that's a mitzvah. To who I did the mitzvah lahashul loykelov v'shar chafetzov." The mitzvah of Gemilat Chasadim is to lend somebody your kelim also, not just your money. Anything that you could do. That's what he says. And he says a very big chiddush here. Oymim Chazal, shemishu tzar ayin milahanes lacherim minchasav. Someone who's not interested in helping out other people with his belongings, uchshem eftzir boy sheyishal, and they push him to lend it to them. Ezo kli, any type of utensil or kli, who mushakiv oymim she'en lei, I don't have it. On shayhu shenegoyim boam al beisai. Then goyim come to his house. He gets a plague on his house. So the Chafetz Chaim writes very strongly that the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim is not just to lend somebody money.
He's bringing it as a riot.
Bringing it as a riot.
Plague.
Yeah.
Because he used to have Negas Saras.
Negas Saras on the houses. So the Chafetz Chaim.
Lending.
Right. So the Chafetz Chaim is being a riot that if you don't lend your Kalim, you get punished for it. According to the Taz, you can't get punished. I'm not mechuyev to do it. I'm not mechuyev to lend out my Kalim. So then the Chafetz Chaim at the bottom has a very interesting thing. So it says like this. How about if somebody has a kli and you lend it out and it does get ruined when you lend it out? It gets used up. So am I mechuyev to lend it out? Am I mechuyev to lend it out my kli? It gets used up. I have something you can use a certain amount of times and after that it can't be used anymore. Am I mechuyev to lend it out? So the Chafetz Chaim is a very interesting thing. It says like this. A poor person who doesn't have money. Is he mechuyev to lend money? No. He doesn't have any extra money. He has no extra money. He barely manages to live on what he has. He doesn't have mechuyev to lend money. Someone comes to him to borrow money. He happens to have $10 in his pocket. He's not mechuyev to give it out because he needs those $10 for tomorrow to buy himself something to eat, or even today. So he's not mechuyev to lend it out. Person who has money that he could lend out, more than he needs, and he can lend it out, he doesn't need it for himself, he's mechuyev to lend it out. So he says, if someone has a chayfetz, and if he lends it out, and people are going to use it, it's going to be used up, and then he's not going to have it for himself. If he doesn't have a chiyuv tzedakah, he doesn't have a chiyuv of halvah, he doesn't have a chiyuv because he doesn't have money, so if he lends out his chayfetz, what's going to end up happening is, it's going to get used up, and he's not going to have a chayfetz for himself, he's not mechuyev to lend it out. Gemilat chasadim is, you have something, let somebody else use it. But if you're not going to be able to use it because he's using it, you're not mechuyev to lend it out. That not.
It's the food and there's no food.
If someone doesn't have enough food for somebody else, he's not mechuyev to invite somebody to his house. He's not mechuyev to give away his food for somebody else if
he
becomes the mitzvah.
He has enough, but just enough. So then the next day he has to go and buy more.
So maybe he's not mechuyev. He's not mechuyev. If a person doesn't have enough for himself, he's not mechuyev to give to somebody else. Of course, if he does it, it's kind of a big mitzvah. No question about it. He's not mechuyev. Says the Chafetz Chaim, you give out a chayfetz, you lend it out to somebody, it's going to get used up, then you're not mechuyev to lend it out. So the same thing l'chayu should be if someone has a car, right? Now we know you lend out your car to somebody, you never know what's going to happen. Now it could be the guy's going to damage it. And let's say the guy does damage it, what happens is your insurance goes up, right? The guy can't afford to pay you for it, and the damage is going to be there, and you're scared it's going to happen. That could be a heter to not lend out the chayfetz. But it has to be. Now this is a very vague. You know, there's no real answer to it, because you could say, wait, you trust the person, that gets an accident. You give a person a pen, he may lose it, he may break it. There are certain things that are makubal, that are accepted by people, that you don't lend out because too much damage could happen if it's lent out. So if someone comes to you and wants to borrow your pen, I'm not giving my pen, you can use up the ink, you may lose it. That's really taking it too far. If someone comes to you and says, I want to borrow your car, and you're hesitant to give it to him because you're scared that something may happen from the car, then a person's potter. Because if damage could happen, which happens a lot, damage could happen that you can't replace it, you can't afford to replace it, your insurance goes up, and then you're paying for the rest of your life a lot more insurance, then a person's potter. Then even the Chafetz Chaim would agree, you don't have to do it, you don't have to give your kelim. But regular kelim, if someone wants to borrow your broom or something from your house, then the Chafetz Chaim says there's a chiv to lend it out, and the Taz says there's no chiv to lend it out. Those are the two shittas over here. The chayr we would go with the Chafetz Chaim, that a person comes to you and asks you for something, even though it's a kelim, it's chafetzim, you're mechuyev to lend it out.
It isn't a chesed. Chesed, if you believe, is the gematria 72.
Yeah.
Yud kei vav kei.
Yeah.
Spelled out is also 72. So when you want to give chesed, you also have a little rachamim. You have that.
Okay. Very good. Very good. There's a Baal Turim. You spell it out. Yud Kei Vav.
Oh, Yud Kei Vav Kei.
There's no damage done to the pot.
Even though there's no damage, you're not equipped to do it.
Because
not damage, it gets used up. Anything gets used. Anything gets used up. Wear and tear, right. Right. The chilek between the Taz and the Chofetz Chaim is wear and tear. You give something, everything has wear and tear. According to the Taz, since it has wear and tear, you're not mechuyev to give it. You lend somebody money, you get it back, you hope you get it back. Then there's no wear and tear. You get back whatever you gave him.
Well, you lose interest.
So that's a question. No, that's a good question. That's a very
today,
good question.
Especially today.
If someone comes to you and wants and asks you, you have a large sum of money, you have $1 million in your bank account, and someone wants to borrow it from you for a year. Now, in that year, you can make interest off it. You can make interest off that money, and you're losing it by lending out the money. You have to lend out the money. The answer is, that money that you would lose from lending it out has a gather of tzedakah. If you have to give tzedakah, and you could afford to give, let's say, $10,000 of tzedakah, so if you lose $10,000 over the year, you could consider that as your tzedakah. That could be part of your tzedakah. But you're not mechuyev to lend out the money if you make money off it and lose the money within the alva.
That's considered tzedakah?
Yes. Could we consider tzedakah? Yes. If you have money that you know, the question is it for sure how much money you're gonna make off it? Sometimes people put money and they lose it. But let's say you have something, you have it, you have a solid investment. You know for sure it's a real estate investment, and you're getting back 7-8% on your money a year. Okay. And the guy wants to borrow the money from you. And you're gonna lose that money if it. You could count that as its tzedakah. You could count that money as its tzedakah.
As meiser money or just?
As meiser money even. That's money you were getting, and now you're not getting it because of it. You count that as its tzedakah.
To get a double mitzvah.
Huh?
Get a double mitzvah.
Yeah, double mitzvah, yeah. So that's the machlokes Taz and Avos Chesed. Now, we spoke before, why don't you make a bracha every time you do Gemilas Chasadim? It's a mitzvah. Do chesed is a mitzvah. Why don't you make a bracha before you go ahead and you do gemilas chasadim? Someone comes to your house, you tell him to sit down, and they give him something to eat. You make a bracha. Bracha to Hashem. Okay, Melchor, Shekhar, Shem, Chazavano, Al gemilas chasadim. Why don't you do that?
You depend on somebody else.
What?
You depend on somebody else.
If somebody's going to get accepted. Okay, so they ask this question by tzedakah. Every time you give tzedakah, you should make a bracha on tzedakah. So one of the Rosh gives a teretz that you may make the bracha and then give the guy the tzedakah. Oh, the guy's going to say, I don't want the tzedakah. Then you didn't do it. You didn't do the tzedakah, right? But a question to this is that by Avraham Avinu it says that he wanted Archim to come. Hashem took out He took out the sun, became very, very hot, and no guest came. When Hashem saw that Avram was mitzayir, that no guests are coming, what did he do? He sent him three malachim dressed up like people. So Avram Avinu ran, did gemilas chasodim. It says in Medrash, he gave them to eat. Did they eat? Malachim don't eat. They made believe like they were eating. Was Avram Mekayim gemilas chasodim or not?
With his heart, come on.
Was Avram Mekayim gemilas chasodim or not? Avram went ahead. The Malachim didn't eat anything. Was it Mekayim gemilas chasodim?
The effort they put into it.
What? The effort they put into it, but he didn't do anything. So a person should make, right, so what happened? Avram Avinu Mekayim gemilas chasodim or not? Yes. So everyone's gonna say, yes, of course it's Mekayim. He tried to, he wanted to. The fact that they didn't eat is not his problem. Right? So we see from Avraham Avinu that Avraham Avinu did what was Mekayim Gemilas Chasadim, and it is called Gemilas Chasadim. You go ahead and you try to do Gemilas Chasadim, and you don't end up doing it because the person didn't eat, you still Mekayim the mitzvah. You still get a reward for doing Gemilas Chasadim. Why? Because Gemilas Chasadim is mitzad, the person doing. What happened at the other end, the Gemara says, we should be machzik toiva l'ramoyim. We have to thank crooks, thieves. Why? Because you give tzedakah a lot of time, and tzedakah you give to thieves, you may end up giving tzedakah to a thief. Right? So the Gemara says, therefore people don't give tzedakah, because they say, I don't know if the guy is legit or not, I don't know if he's okay or not. But let's say a guy went ahead and he gave tzedakah to one of those people, he didn't know. He thought it was good and it wasn't good. Is it kind of mitzvah tzedakah? You would not. Why not? He said, why isn't the Gemara's Chasodim? Avraham Avinu, I asked before, Avraham Avinu is Mekhaim Gemara's Chasodim. Tzedakah, you say you're not Mekhaim. What's the difference?
There is a difference.
What's the difference? Gemara's Chasodim and Tzedakah? I don't know the difference. I would say if you're Mekhaim Gemara's Chasodim, say it with Tzedakah.
It's Tzedakah, if you lose it, then only finds it.
Yeah, but then only got it. Here no one got it.
Didn't even have the intention.
Yeah, but here no one got it.
I hear.
Here's the opposite, no one got it. No one was nana from it. Could we still Mekhaim the Tzedakah? If that's the case, then you shouldn't make a bracha on Tzedakah, because you want to give the Tzedakah. The person's not accepting it. So you should get the mitzvah from it. So it's another territory that's given
the
is
reason,
that...
The reason, I heard. Well, if they made a bracha, some people would look for a hat. Some people would say, he didn't become a zuman.
So I'll tell you,
pay her till you got it.
So I'll tell you two truths. One territory brought down is that you don't make a bracha with somebody else coming onto somebody else's pain. Tzedakah is because the guy's an ani. He has no money. So the way you mekayim tzedakah is because that person doesn't have enough. We don't make a bracha on a mitzvah they're doing because of somebody else's pain. A very nice, very nice teretz.
Brismila.
Brismila is also, yeah. So, you make a bracha, make shechiyana.
But not shechiyana.
Make shechiyana because that's a tzadinuk. Yeah. But it's not, that's a different type of pain. Okay, it's a different type of pain. So that's one teretz. So you ask somebody, you know, who owns a funeral home? How's business going? You can't say Baruch Hashem.
Booming,
Baruch Hashem. What's he going to say, right? You can't say that. So the same thing, you don't make a bracha when it's coming onto pain by somebody else. One teretz. Another teretz I heard, it's a shkafa teretz, is that you don't make a person, what's going to happen is you give it tzedakah, similar to what you were saying. You give tzedakah, you make a bracha, you're making the ani into a cheftza de mitzvah. You're making this person, that he is a cheftza de mitzvah. Don't make a person your means of a mitzvah. He feels stupid. I'm making a bracha shkaich, thank you very much. You know, I've said over the story already about this guy. Baruch Hashem, I said made you with an ani so I can mechayim the mitzvah. Yeah. I said over the guy who, a person met his friend on Purim. He was all excited. And he asked him, why are you so excited about it? I said, this year I'm telling you I found an ani, that he's an ani l'chol ha-shittus or l'chol ha-deyus. There's a penny to his name. So his friend tells him, no, tell me who he is. I also want to give. No, I'm saving him for next year. don't use aniyim as a chef to the mitzvah. So that's another reason why we don't make a bracha on tzedakah. But the question is, gemilas chasodim is not that way. You invite somebody to your house, right, for a suda. He's not a nebuch, right? He's not only gemilas chasodim, a filo b'ashirim. Yeah, but didn't gemilas chasodim. You invite somebody to your house for a suda, you mekayim gemilas chasodim. So all these terutzim by tzedakah, you don't have by gemilas chasodim. So why to make a bracha on gemilas chasodim? Well, yeah, you should make a bracha on gemilas chasodim. So I saw a teretz, a very nice teretz. And the teretz is that brachas we make on mitzvahs, that if not for the fact that Hashem told us to do it, we wouldn't be doing it. Bismila, you know, lulav, matzah, sitting in a sukkah, tefillin, tzitzis. Without Hashem telling us to do it, we wouldn't have been doing the mitzvahs. But our mitzvahs that we would have done without Hashem telling us to do it, anyway, milas chasadim is a davar sichli. It makes sense to do it. Things that we'll be doing even without the commanding of Hashem, but now we don't say Baruch Atah Hashem because we're showing we're only doing it because Hashem told us to do it. If not for that, we wouldn't have done it.
Like Shabbos Aveda, maybe.
Shabbos Aveda, right? You don't make a Baruch on Shabbos Aveda. Right? Maybe for the same reason. All these mitzvahs that are mitzvahs sichlius that make sense, we don't make a Baruch on them. So I saw a teretz, interesting teretz. And so I have one aura on that teretz. But I have a Kabbalah from my Rebbe, the Ravinsky Rebbe Shlita, that he says, if you look in the Parshias by Avram, and Avram did Chesed, and it says that when Eliezer went and found Rivka, right? So he saw that he was Gomel Chesed, she gave to drink, and he said, oh, she must be the one for Yitzchak. He says, what's the Raya? The Gomel also Gomel Chesed. The Gomel also do Lavan. Did Gemilas Chasadim? What's the difference?
She went beyond the call of duty.
What's the difference?
She did it sechelit.
So
with the camel later.
No.
She
so,
did like a
so he says he was medayik in the psukim. It says in the psukim by Rivka Every time she went, it says the lashon of rot. She ran. She ran to do the mitzvah. But Lavan, it says, he went. Vayelech. And he went. And he did it. And he said, I'll never forget it. He said, b'zeh lashon, he said, so a mitzvah, to a mitzvah, loiftmin, you run. So to gemilas chesed, gateman. If you're doing it for gemilas chesed, because it's sichlius, then you go. You don't have to run. But if it's a mitzvah, if you're doing it for a mitzvah, then you run. Why? Because a mitzvah is done different than davar sechli. That's what he said. And now, if you look at Avraham Avinu, if you go back to the Parsha, you see, what's the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim? Is the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim to go ahead and the Ani comes to your house, and then you do Gemilas Chasadim? Or the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim even to do more? To go ahead and look for Aniyim, to go ahead and try to help people? So the answer is the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim. I'm not talking about the seichel of Gemilas Chasadim. The seichel of Gemilas Chasadim is, yeah, a guy comes, so you have to help him out. But you wonder what the mitzvah is? The mitzvah, you look at Avraham. The mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim is, yes, to go look for someone to be going with chesed to. That's the chel between a mitzvah and a davar sichli. A davar sichli, if you're doing it because the seichel says you should do it, it's a good thing to do, then you don't have to look for it. But if you're doing it because of the mitzvah, that we learn from Avraham Avinu, that a mitzvah is done differently. A mitzvah is done to run and to go find people to do it to.
I was running for the mitzvah too.
Avraham is rot. Yeah, Avraham is, it says by Avraham. Vayimaher. It says, Hosam Vayimaher, he went quickly and he brought it. Why? Because Avraham was doing a L'shem mitzvah. He was not doing a L'shem because that's the right thing to do because of Seichel. That's a big difference. So we can ask somebody a question. The mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim, is it a mitzvah to go ahead and find guests? Or is it a mitzvah to go ahead, when someone comes to you, make sure you treat him correctly and give him what he wants? The answer is, if it's a mitzvah, it's a mitzvah to go find somebody. That's the answer. A mitzvah, yeah. Seichel, you don't have to find somebody. And that was from Avraham Avinu in this week's Pasha.